So good morning everyone, my name is Umang Goswami and I work as an educator in Unacademy. So today we'll be discussing on the topic of drying, and you can follow my lessons and courses. For that you will have to download the Unacademy learning app. So please share these videos and do subscribe to the YouTube channel of Unacademy. Till then, thank you. So good morning everyone and welcome to the lesson of drying in the mass transfer in the chemical engineering discipline. So today we'll be starting with the thermodynamics of drying system, that how it works. So you in on the screen you can see some unbound, free moisture and bound moisture. All these things are written, we will discuss them in detail. So the most important concept here is of relative humidity. Now what happens is, like, the hot air has a minimum value of moisture in it, whereas the solid has the maximum moisture. So if you keep it, then what happens for a particular interval of time? Then the hot air first of all removes the moisture content from the solid. So the solid is now having less moisture content, whereas the hot air is having more moisture content. Okay, so if this process is continued, then what happens next? The solid will again get wet, whereas the air will be the air will also have some moisture content in it, but that will not be a very large value. So this is the concept of relative humidity. So relative humidity is always shown by P0A upon PAV, where partial pressure of pure water and PAV is vapor pressure of pure water. So that means it can be of any component. So partial pressure upon vapor pressure is known as the relative humidity. Now we also already discussed that when the solid is initially dried, okay, then unbound moisture is removed. That means the moisture which is free in nature, okay, or technically speaking, which is unbound in nature, okay. So initially P0A is equals to PAV, so therefore relative humidity is equals to 1, and this region is known as the unbound region. Now after this, what happens? We said that some dry patches are formed and vapor pressure becomes greater than the partial pressure. So now important terms here are equilibrium moisture content. So when you look at this part, this is known as the equilibrium moisture content. So, and we said that after you reach the equilibrium moisture content, further drying cannot take place, okay. So this part is known as the equilibrium moisture. This small square is known as the equilibrium moisture content. Now we also know that the amount of moisture that can be removed will be the free moisture content, okay. So free moisture content will be the moisture content that is in excess to the equilibrium moisture content. If we have to remove some amount of moisture, then that needs to be free moisture content, okay. Whereas unbound moisture content, we just now witnessed that whatever is free to vaporize, that means whatever it's present on the surface of the solid, that is known as unbound moisture content. Whereas bound moisture content, now bound moisture content includes both free moisture content as well as equilibrium moisture content, okay, because these are bound. But we know that only free moisture content can be removed, whereas equilibrium moisture content cannot be removed. Now we look at look into the definitions where you can understand this concept clearly. So first of all, bound moisture, the amount of moisture content in a solid that exerts a vapor pressure less than the normal vapor pressure of water at a given temperature is called bound moisture. Okay, so read this definition, you will understand what it is trying to say. Second, unbound moisture, the amount of moisture in a wet solid in excess of the bound moisture is called unbound moisture. Now in excess of the bound moisture, yes, we can see that bound moisture is still here and unbound moisture is in excess of bound moisture. Similarly, equilibrium moisture content, the moisture content in a solid that can remain in equilibrium with the drying medium of a given relative humidity at a given temperature is called equilibrium moisture. Because we know that after certain time, an equilibrium relation will be established where the transfer will not take place. Okay, so that is equilibrium moisture content. And finally, the free moisture content. The moisture in wet solid in excess of the equilibrium moisture content is called free moisture content. Okay, so in excess of equilibrium moisture is known as free moisture content. And remember one thing, only free moisture can be removed by drying. Equilibrium moisture cannot be removed, only free moisture can be removed. Now in case of drying, we have hysteresis. Now hysteresis you might have learned in the magnetic field of which you might have studied in the physics in class 9th or 11th. Now here the thing is, hysteresis is observed when now there are two cases. Suppose you are wetting the solid and suppose you are drying the solid. It is never the same case. Okay, wetting the solid will follow different path. That means it will reach to a particular composition differently by following a different path, whereas drying will be followed in a different path. So that is, when we undergo drying, that follows different path, and when moisture is, and moisture follows different path. Okay, so when we are drying, it follows different path, and when moisture is added, it follows different path. So wetting and drying both follows different paths. In rate of drying, if we consider area of drying, then as moisture is removed, drying area varies. Okay, so what we do, so in order to remove this complexion, what we do, area of solid is considered as the required area for drying. We do not consider area on the wet basis or on the basis of dry basis. We only consider the area of solid. So in the next lecture we will be covering some more topics. Till then, thank you.